leverage with stocks. I mean, you can buy on margins, but it's very hard to borrow and then buy stocks. With real estate, if I buy a $100,000 home, all I need is $25,000. So with $25,000, I can control a $100,000 asset. And the other piece is inflation. I mean, there's a lot of talk of inflation right now. We don't know it's coming, if it's coming, when it's coming. I'm not too worried about inflation, because as inflation comes, as prices go up, I will increase my rent. So I have a hedge for inflation. As prices go up, I will be able to offset that with higher rents, with additional rent income. And the last piece, which sometimes gets forgotten, is the social impact that comes with real estate investing. Josh and I, we employ a lot of people. We have a lot of contractors, plumbers, AC technicians. There's a lot of, the way we get the money in, usually we like to deploy it and reinvest it. So we constantly have to pay somebody and support somebody. I'm sure there's some guys bringing their kids through college through what Josh and I have paid to them, which are all well deserved. And you also have the social impact of creating living space. I mean, the way Josh and I go about it, we take properties that need a lot of work, that they're neglected for years, bad condition, just dirty, not really taken care of, landlords not taking care of it, and we renovate them. We make them nice. We make them nice, safe living spaces. And we were able to get a premium on our rents, but at the same time, people appreciate it. People want to live in our house. I mean, the apartment building we have in Mobile, we have a wait list, because it's not in the best area of Mobile, but our property is definitely the best or the nicest in that area. So there is a wait list. People want to live in our places. Even though our rent is a little bit higher than comparable assets, but they still want to live there. So there's a social impact that comes with real estate investing. It can be rewarding too, as you see things progress.